Hello everyone, my name is Shambhavi. Hope you all are doing well. So today we are going to discuss regarding the DQL commands, that is the data query language commands, right? So this is one of the topics which we have already discussed previously, but yeah, we had only discussed regarding that what is DQL commands, what is it used for, and what are the sub commands which come under this, right? We haven't seen out the syntaxes, we haven't seen out the examples, and all those things we haven't done that thing till now, right? So today we are going to see regarding all of the commands which we have in the DQL commands, right? So basically, if you remember when we had studied about the DQL commands, in that case we just studied that DQL command only consists of one single command, one single function into that, and that is actually the select command, right? SELECT. Select command is one of the only commands which comes under the DQL commands. But what's the more thing here? The more next thing that comes here is that the select command, which is actually in the DQL commands, it has many sub queries into it. Sub queries, or you can just call it clauses actually. Okay, it has many sub clauses into it with the help of which the select commands are actually used. So we'll be seeing out the select command as well as the all the clauses for the select command which we actually have out, right? Let me just go on to the DQL file. Right, here it was. Let's give a quick revision regarding the data query language. So it is statements are used for performing the queries onto the data within the objects. So the purpose of the DQL command is to get some schema relation based on the query passed to it, right? And this was basically the query which was select one. And it is absolutely used for retrieving out some data from the database. That is absolutely the true thing, right? Okay, let's get started with the select command. So I would just write that particular command here itself, select, okay? Fine, that is absolutely done here. Now, what do we have? First of all, I'll be writing out the syntax for the select command that we actually have. Okay, so the syntax for my select command is, I would just write here, first of all, select, and here comes the column. Okay, just one second. That is column list. Okay, here comes the from, and after that, after the from, I'm just writing out it downside because there is no space above. So here comes the table name. So the first arrow column in which I just put on these arrows, inside that I just wrote out the column list, right? So this column list is basically the whatever the columns you just want to select from a particular table, that column names you need to enter here into the first one. Okay, and from table name is basically the name of your table which you are actually having. Right, so I would be just writing both of these things here as well, so that you just get out the proper thing regarding this. So let's say here I have that table name is the name of the table. Let me come down. Table name is the name of the table from which the information is retrieved. Okay, retrieved. Right, so table name is the name of the table from which the information is retrieved. Hey, this is the thing that is absolutely okay actually. After this, we were having the column list that as well I mentioned. So column list. And what is this column list? So it includes, column list includes, it includes one or more columns from which data is retrieved. Retrieved like this. Okay, so this is the column list. I just told you regarding both of the things, that first of all, what is the table name, after that what is the column list, which these two parameters we were actually having onto our select statement which we had written out. Right, now okay, just let me come down here and quickly just let me define out some columns and a quick database here. So here we go with this particular thing, and After this, I could just make several lines inside this. Let's say we have one column. Okay, let's say we have one column. After that, so here comes our second column. After that, again, now here comes my third and the fourth column, like this, right? This is absolutely okay. We had just made out some of the columns which we wanted in our database, and yes, okay. Now I would be just writing out the names for these columns which we had made out, that what are the names that are actually here. So writing out that, let's say first one is the admission number, okay. Second one is basically, let's say, name. Third one, let's say I have here as gender. Fourth is, let's say, I have age. Okay, so let's say these are the four. Okay, let that be age, and let's make out one more column as well here, like this. And that would actually belong to the place, right? So here comes the age, and this is the place. Fine, let's say these are the five columns which I have onto my data, which I had, right, database which I've taken out. So let's say admission number is 100. 101, 102, 103, 104, 105, 106, and here it was a 107. Let's say these are the number of rows which I am having onto my data. So let's say some names are there, for them the gender is there, for them the age, for them the place. I'm just not gonna fill out the whole data here. Like I just gave you an idea for that particular thing, right? So that this table name, the table name which I'll be giving right here to this table is, I'll be writing the name, and that is actually the student table. Fine, this is the name that I wanted to give out to this particular table. Fine. Now let's say I just want to select out some particular columns from this data which I am having. Fine, I'm having the columns which are admission number, name, gender, age, and place. Let's say I just want to select admission number and name. So for that, how will I be writing out my select statement? So select, write out the column list whichever you just want to do. So for me, it is admission number, comma, and we have name as well, right? And here comes the from, and after from I'll be writing out that particular table name in which these two columns belong. So that table name for here for me I'm having as a student, and putting out the semicolon at the last. This is basically the statement that we will be going through whenever we just want to select out any particular columns from our data set. That you are absolutely clear with, because this is one of the things which we had already discussed in some of the previous videos, because this is one of the commands which is similar, but here we are just going to discuss out some different keywords and the clauses for the select statement, okay? Right, and if you just want to view out the whole data, whole database, so in that case, we just simply write select asterisk from student. So select, let me write that as well, it will not take more than 1 minute. So select, put out that asterisk sign, which is the multiplication sign actually. Select asterisk, here comes from, and after from you'll be writing your table name. So that is the student for me, and putting in the semicolon. Right, this is how we just do out the things. Fine, the select statement is absolutely okay, that is absolutely clear. We had done out the things regarding this. Now the very first topic which comes here, the very first keyword which we will be discussing here under this select statement, that is distinct keyword. Okay, that is distinct keyword. Now the very first question arises, that why is this distinct keyword used? Like, what's the use of this particular thing? Still we are having many commands under the SQL, so why we should use out this keyword with the select command, right? So it is, as I mentioned, that it is used along with the select command. Now what is it used for? It is absolutely used for eliminating out the duplicate rows into the table. Okay, so let's say you are having one row, and that similar row is present 3 to 4 times onto your table. So what is that? That is actually the redundant data that you are having, right? So this is the use of the distinct keyword only, that it basically helps you to eliminate and remove out the duplicate rows whichever you are having into your table. right? So in the one on the stems, we can just say that this helps to eliminate out the redundant data. Okay, so hope you just got that idea. Now how we just use this with the help of the select statement. So absolutely the command is simpler. So I would just write here select, and here comes the distinct keyword which we are having, select distinct. Let's say what I'll be using this according to the place. Okay, let's say I just want to remove all of those rows which have similar places. Okay, let's say this is my case. So in that case, let me come down, select distinct. I would be writing place. Okay, select distinct place. Here comes the from, that what is the table name from which we need to do out, right? To select distinct place from, and after that we have the table name which is actually student. So I just put on that particular place here. Select distinct place from student, right? This is the idea regarding this particular distinct statement. So what it will do, whatever the places you are having out here, so in that place it will search out the distinct rows, and it will so like show you all of those rows here as an output from you, for you. Okay, so hope you just got the idea regarding first of all that how we just use out this distinct keyword. First of all, you'll be using out the distinct keyword, and after that you can just write out select asterisk from a student. So that will basically give the whole data regarding the students of the different places and all those things. It will just give you as an output to you, right? Hope you are very much okay with that. After the distinct keyword, we have the second, which is all keyword. So second topic comes here, that is all, and here goes the all keyword like this, right? Now what it is actually used out, so it is the all keyword actually retains out the duplicate rows. It means that it will display every row of the table without considering the duplicate entries. Okay, it basically retains out the duplicate rows. It means that it will display every row of the table without considering the duplicate entries. Okay, in that case, if your let's say if your particular any of the column is having some duplicate places as well. Let's say I just took out this column which is place. Okay, and your data is having some duplicate places as well. So it will display all of the rows whichever you are having onto your data. Okay, it will not eliminate anyone. It will as you are giving the as the things are mentioned onto your data, it will similarly copy all those things and mention to you as an output. Fine, so let me just show you that how we just write out. So here comes the select, as these are all the keywords which come under the select command only. So it's compulsory to always first of all use out the select command, then choose your keyword accordingly, right? Select all. Let's say place is the column which I want to go ahead from, and after that we have the student. Select all place from student, and here goes the semicolon, right? So what this particular command will do, this particular command will actually give you all the data which you have onto this particular column which is place. Either it is duplicate or it is distinct, it will give you each and everything. Let's say Chennai is present 3 times onto your data. So it will display that particular place, that is Chennai, 3 times onto your as an output for you. So it will not eliminate anything as you have used out the all keyword. Right? So hope you just got the idea regarding this all keyword and regarding this distinct keyword. Other than that, you have got the idea regarding the select command. Other than these two keywords, we have many more keywords and many more clauses onto the select command that we'll be discussing in the further videos. So this is all for this video. Till then, thank you and take care.